Good morning, good morning, good morning. I am out walking my dog. It's the thing to do, apparently. That's when I have all my time to do my live videos and my Instagram stories. Ah, what a beautiful morning. Not a cloud in the sky. Blue as anything. Not too hot, not too cold. Birds are out. Feeling very grateful about living in such a beautiful place. And probably won't be grateful when you hit those hot days when it's like 40 degrees, but generally feeling really happy. So I had a lovely day yesterday, like really, really nice day. I don't know if anyone saw my stories, but my sister Diane and I went up to up behind Montville for a bit of a day trip. We went up there to help facilitate, well, not help, we did facilitate a cacao circle, which was, oh, it was just amazing. So our beautiful friend Michelle Freeman runs these yoga retreats, and that's the one that Di and I, you'll see, we always go to at Pumpkin Island. And it's, oh god, I'm going in circles now. And just, oh, she's just got the most beautiful, beautiful presence about her. She's so calm and she just attracts these lovely ladies. And anyway, so she's running a yoga retreat at the back of Montville and asked if I would come up and do a cacao circle for her. And I said, I'd love to. Can I bring my sister? She's met Di. Yeah, yeah. It was just such a lovely day. So we drove up there. We were basically in the car for probably nearly 4.5 hours yesterday, but it was well worth it. Drove up there, ran the circle. Everyone just shared so openly and vulnerably. And you just never know with circles how deep people are going to go. If you've never done any sort of circle work, it's basically, it just gives you permission to share and be heard, and without people's opinions, without people's advice, with no judgment. And it doesn't happen very regularly in our lives. Like, we're constantly being judged and constantly having everyone give their opinion. In love, they mean it. But you start telling your story and then someone comes and, oh, well, that happened to me and I think you should do this. So it's just lovely to actually just sit and be heard and be given permission to cry if you need to cry, to just let stuff out. Take the mask off is basically what we do. And we set that intention pretty early in the circle, and it's just amazing to watch complete strangers. They weren't, because they'd been on a retreat, but sometimes when we do these circles, people are complete strangers to each other anyway. And we start off with a bit of gratitude and intention, which we did yesterday. And seriously, as soon as people started talking about the gratitude and their intentions, it was on. People's lips were quivering. There was tears, and I was like, oh, this is what it's all about. So it's just giving women and men permission to be themselves, permission to cry, to grieve, to heal, to do what it takes without, yeah, judgment or fear of being looked at big silly because you're crying. And one of the rules, not rules, but you know what I mean, in circle is that we don't go hugging people, because what happens when you hug someone, it's subconsciously, and everyone means well, and I've done it myself, you go and hug someone that's crying and pat them and tell them it's okay. One, it's telling them it's not okay to cry. I'm hugging you because I'm trying to stop you crying, because that's not okay. And secondly, it's making me feel uncomfortable that you're crying, so I'm going to hug you to stop you crying because I don't know what else to do. Which is beautiful and heartfelt, and I've done it for many, many years, and I still hug people all the time. But when we're doing this type of work, it's really important that we acknowledge them, acknowledge the fact that they're crying, acknowledge that it's okay to cry, like it's not a bad thing, and letting them let it out and just holding space for them pretty much energetically. You don't have to touch someone to hold space for them, and they don't have to be touched to feel supported. When you've got 8 or 10 women sitting in circle allowing you to cry, allowing you to grieve, allowing you just to let it out, that's more powerful than running up and giving them a hug like would happen in the real world. So it was really interesting, and people had some massive breakthroughs, and I watched connections, I watched connections being formed. It was just, it's literally why I do what I do. I love it. So if you ever get a chance to come to one of my circles, I run them once a month on usually the first Friday of the month. Unfortunately, next one's not till January because just December's way too busy. But yeah, just keep an eye on all my stuff, and it's all on our website. You can get on there and book in now for the next one if you're keen. And don't be scared, like everyone's scared. Like it's just that thing that everyone thinks everyone else is some bloody spiritual goddess or guru, and they're friggin' not, including me, just quietly. We are all just living life, doing the best we can do. We have our good days, we had our bad days. I had a bloody shit day the other day. Again, if you saw my story, it was only the day before yesterday, feels like eternity, but I felt shit. I felt, oh, so flat. I was comparing myself to people. I felt not good enough. I felt fearful. I was ready to quit everything. Oh, it was horrible. I think I cried about 400 times in one day for no apparent reason. And I was frustrated. I was angry. I was emotional. I was just having a shit day, basically. And it was just one of those days where you just have to, oh, my dog's about to bark at someone. You just have to get over yourself. Hello, Hayley, or anyone else that's watching. Yes, so we all have them. And it's a matter of just knowing, okay, we're all freaking human. We're all in this together. We're just on this thing. I call it the roller coaster of life. Some days I wish my roller coaster was a little bit more flat-lined. Seems to be a fair up and down at the moment, but with every high, there has to be a low. It's just, it's physics. It's opposites. For one polarity of something, there's a polarity on the other end. For love, there's hate. For black, there's white. It can't exist. We can't exist in this world without the opposite. So you can't have all the good stuff without the shitty stuff that's attached to it. And the quicker you realize that, and the quicker you, when you're in the shitty stuff, and look, it's easy for me to sit here and tell you this now because I'm out of it, but when you're in it, the best thing you can do is to freaking just sit in it. Sit in your shit, cry, sulk. I did it. I threw myself in the bed. I had a tantrum. I was like, this is shit. I'm a fraud. All of the shit come out. And just be with it and know that it will pass. And I said, it's so easy for me to say this now because, you know, the next day after that, I have the most amazing day ever. Dog, what are you doing? Peeing. Dogs always pee. Anyway, that's all the serious stuff I just want to talk about and say hello to you all. I was watching my friend Jay do his live videos last night, and I absolutely love them. They're friggin' hilarious. And I'm like, I hope mine are that exciting. He's like fishing spider webs off his face, and he's jumping fences, and oh, it's great. And puffing like me, because we don't walk slowly. He's hilarious. And I was thinking, oh, I should do more live videos, because I really enjoy watching his. And I thought, oh, I think people say to me they like my live videos. So, because it's just random. You just get whatever comes on the day. Dogs barking, attacked by birds half the day, half the time. And anyway, today's a good day. The day before yesterday was shit, and that's life. That's the lesson from my live video today. I don't think anyone's even watching, but they watch it later. If you watch later, give me a hashtag replay. I always like to see who's watched, because it's pointless me doing this if no one's watching it. It's to help people. I want to help you by being in my own shitness. I want to help you just by being authentic and real and vulnerable and true. And I think that's what I do really well. I reckon I'm really good at being real. Lots of people tell me that, and I'm like, it's so true. I'm good at just being me, and you see it all. The good, the bad, and the flippin' ugly. All right, I'm gonna go. Thank you for watching. If you're watching late, Jimmy Rowe, I got your cacao water. It's getting packed up as we speak, so we can order, work out for you to pick that up next week. And yeah, go back and watch the start, Jimmy, because the circles that I'm telling you about is not just for women. We're getting men involved as well. So, and in saying that, there's heaps of men stuff out there. It's all just coming out. It's amazing how many men's groups there are, because men need this stuff as much as women. They just need to be heard and to be say, it's okay to not be okay. It's okay to feel like shit. It's okay to have a bad day. Anyway, now I'm really puffing. I must be walking really super duper fast, which I am. I am fit, believe you. I promise I'm fit. Anyway, I'm going to go. Thank you for listening to me ramble on. As I said, make sure you comment so I know you've been watching. I love you all so much. Big hugs. Bye.